Today, I'm going to show you a technique for separating mixtures of soluble substances. This method is called chromatography. Forensic scientists use chromatography to detect false documents by looking at colours present in inks. It's also an important technique for testing unknown substances in food and drink. And in medicine, chromatography plays an important role looking at the purity and safety of drugs. We're going to use paper chromatography to see what colours are in different inks. I'm going to use chromatography filter paper and three inks to see if they are pure or impure. Find the full methods, safety information, and activities in the supporting resources. First, draw a pencil line a short way from the bottom of the paper, like this. This is the origin line. The pencil is not soluble in water, so it won't affect the experiment. You'll find out why this is important in a moment. Label the paper with samples 1, 2, and 3. I now need to add a small amount of my first sample by dipping a capillary tube into the ink, just like this. My second sample is a different black ink, and the third sample is an orange ink that I think is pure. I'm now going to add them. I'm using water as the solvent. We call the solvent the mobile phase because it moves. If an ink is soluble in water, paper chromatography will separate all the substances, the different colours, in it. Now add 2 milliliters of water into the beaker with a pipette. I need to carefully set up the chromatography paper in the beaker. We call the paper the stationary phase as it does not move. The paper must sit vertically, like this, and not curved, or otherwise the inks will move up at an angle. I'm going to line up the paper outside the beaker so I can measure how long it needs to be. Keep the paper in place by wrapping it around a splint and securing it with a paper clip. Like this. Lower the paper carefully into the beaker, just so it touches the water. You can see that the ink samples on the pencil line are above the water. This is important. If the water level was higher than the ink samples, the soluble samples would dissolve in the water and there'd be none left on the filter paper. I will leave the beaker and its contents until the water has reached just below the paperclip. Remove the filter paper from the water to stop the inks moving further. This paper with the separated colours is called a chromatogram. I can leave the chromatogram to dry in a warm place or use a hairdryer. Now before I do this, I need to draw where the solvent has got to. This is the solvent front. Let's look at the results. The black ink in sample 1 contained blue, orange, and pink. It is impure. Sample 2 didn't separate and is still on the origin line. This is because sample 2 is insoluble in water, so we don't know if it's pure or impure. Sample 3 shows that the orange ink is pure. We know this because it only has one spot of colour on the chromatogram. The orange spots in samples 1 and 3 have travelled the same distance up the paper. This tells us that they are the same substance. The different substances that make up the inks separated and travelled different distances up the paper due to how soluble they are in water. Their movement depends on whether they have a stronger attraction for the mobile phase or the stationary phase. The sample 2 black ink has the strongest attraction for the stationary phase, because it's the slowest to move up the paper. In this case, it was so slow it didn't move at all. The blue colour has the strongest attraction for the mobile phase and is the most soluble because it's the quickest to move up the paper. You could repeat the experiment again with a different mobile phase to try to separate sample 2. I used ethanol as the solvent instead of water on the same 3 samples. If you test ethanol, make sure to wear safety glasses. Because ethanol evaporates easily, add a lid to the beaker when using it. You can see from these results that sample 2 is soluble in ethanol and contains only black ink. You can also repeat this experiment by changing the stationary phase. There is a very sensitive method using a silica powder on a plastic backing called thin layer chromatography, or TLC. The TLC plate can separate the chemicals, such as amino acids. When you can't see the results, you can use an anhydrous spray or UV light to make them visible. Scientific researchers often use TLC plates rather than the chromatography paper that I use today. Now calculate the RF value, the ratio of solutes distance travelled to the solvents distance travelled for each colour on your chromatogram. Let's start with the orange colour. I need to know the distance of the solute from the origin line. The colour is quite spread out, so I'm going to stop my line in the middle of the orange spot. Let me get a little mark on it here. The measurement here is 5.0 centimeters. I also need to know the distance from the solvent front to the origin line. This is 5.3 centimeters. To find out the RF value for each color, you divide the distance traveled by the solute, the color, by the distance the solvent, the water, traveled. For the orange color in water, the RF value is 5.0 divided by 5.3, which equals 0.94 to 2 decimal places. Now I'll repeat this for the other colors. Remember to download the supporting resources from the RSC educational website. Thank you for watching and have fun with your experiments.